Welcome to the Heavy Spoilers Show. I'm your host Definition, aka your friendly neighborhood spoiler man, and this is the channel where we break down all the latest movies, new game releases, TV shows, and comic books. After the release of the Black Widow trailer yesterday, I thought it was time to discuss one of the most enigmatic figures from the teaser. That person is Taskmaster, the shadowy mercenary that seems to be hot on the heels of our hero Natasha throughout the entirety of the film. Throughout this video, we'll be discussing everything that you need to know about Taskmaster, including his origins from the comic books, and also the character's powers and abilities. We'll also be going over some of the leaks from the film on who the character could really be. Because of this, there will be heavy spoilers, so if you don't want anything about the movie potentially ruined, then I highly suggest that you turn off now. I'll be giving you another spoiler warning before we get into the fan theories and plot leaks for the movie, so don't worry if you just want to know the character's backstory. With that out of the way, I just want to give a huge thank you for clicking this video. Now let's get into our breakdown of Taskmaster. Okay, so Taskmaster was created by David Michelinie and George Perez all the way back in 1980 in Avengers issue 195. Though his appearance was rather short-lived in this entry, mainly popping up just to provide a cliffhanger, the character soon went on to become a massive adversary for the Marvel characters, and now he has a legacy that spans almost 40 years. Taskmaster initially wished to be a superhero, but failing that, he became a villain, using his abilities for personal gain rather than the good of mankind. Still, over the years, the character has pretty much become an anti-hero at this point, blurring the lines between good and bad through his actions. This has made him fascinating for fans who've watched him cross sides over his long and rich history. Taskmaster has worked with both good and bad, and this has meant that many comic book readers have been able to relate with him over the years. Taskmaster, real name Tony Masters, though not a superpowered being per se, has photographic reflexes which allow him to remember an action perfectly upon seeing it. A literal copycat, the character has almost an intimate knowledge of every villain and hero's combat moves within the Marvel lineup. With this knowledge, he can mimic a person's abilities and learn their fighting style almost instantly, thus being able to replicate it himself or use knowledge of it to best his opponent easily. Anything you can do, Taskmaster can do better, and if you run into him down a dark alley, then you better prepare to have all the moves from the best Marvel heroes thrown at you. Taskmaster was injected with a replica of the Super Soldier Serum that created Captain America. However, rather than gifting him with strength and enhanced healing abilities, it instead increased his memory massively. Because of this, Taskmaster has a perfect memory and can recall every moment of his life as if he was there in the moment, meaning that after he has went head to head with someone, he can analyze the battle and pick apart all of their weaknesses and tells that he noticed during it. This has made him a master martial artist and someone that is one of the best hand-to-hand fighters in all of comic books. However, this is limited strictly to human movement rather than superhuman movement, and there have been several times when copying someone has backfired, most notably in the case of the living cartoon character Slapstick, in which mimicking their movements ended up leading to Taskmaster breaking his own back. Yikes. Taskmaster also has struggled in the past with Deadpool due to the character's off-the-wall mind state, which makes him difficult to predict and understand on a psychological level. However, the character has bested the likes of Iron Man, the Hulk, Ant-Man, and Spider-Man in the recent PlayStation 4 game. Due to this, the villain is in high demand, and this has caused him to receive contracts from the evil entities like Hydra and so on. Skill-wise, though the character may not be up there with the A-listers, when it comes to an out-and-out brawler, Taskmaster is probably on a level with the likes of Daredevil, Shang-Chi, and Bullseye. He too packs an arsenal of weapons with him that means he can duplicate and counter any attack that comes his way. He carries a shield and sword too, meaning that he can go head to head with the likes of Captain America and other members of the Avengers that have bladed weapons without any real problems. What makes Taskmaster such a sought after character is that he can also teach those that hire him their opponents' fighting moves. Imagine training your soldiers by having them fighting against a guy who can brawl like Black Widow, you'd soon have a legion of people that could counter her every move, and because of this, Taskmaster is one of the most dangerous people in the Marvel Universe. The coach has trained Crossbones, John Walker, aka US Agent, and many more to fight like their opponents, and people they are filling the shoes of, and chances are that some of your favorite heroes have either had a run-in or have been helped by the character in the past. In more recent years, Taskmaster has gained more popularity due to his appearances in a range of games and TV shows. Not only has he appeared in the aforementioned Spider-Man 4, but the character has also featured in Marvel vs. Capcom 3, LEGO Marvel Super Heroes, and in the director-DVD movie Heroes United, Iron Man and Captain America. In these entries, he often provides tasks, because of his name, in which the heroes have to perform special moves that will allow him to study their abilities. This was a big aesthetic in the Spider-Man game, in which he would provide the webhead with missions and then use these challenges to study his moves before taking the wall crawler on face to face. Taskmaster is also set to feature in the upcoming Marvel Avengers game, and from the recently released demo footage that was shown earlier in the year, he was seen going head to head against Black Widow on the bridge set piece that kickstarts the game. Whether he will feature in a bigger capacity or not is unknown, but he could definitely provide a worthy foe for Widow, which leads us into his biggest appearance in 2020, which will no doubt be in the Black Widow solo movie. In the trailer, we see Taskmaster chasing the titular character and her allies through the streets, labs, and even the air. I have seen some people take it as being Hawkeye under the mask due to his bow and arrow, but I highly doubt that this is the case. However, he may have mimicked Hawkeye's moves and therefore be able to copy them completely, using a similar bow and arrow to the character in order to take Widow down. I can definitely see this being a possibility, as he will no doubt have studied the likes of Clint Barton and the Avengers in order to be able to contend with some of the best fighters on the planet. I bet he can snap like Thanos too. Now, recently there have been a lot of complaints about why the look of Taskmaster has been changed so heavily for the film, with many complaining that you wouldn't even know it was the character unless you were told this was the case. This is actually because of the strict rules about showing skulls in China. The country has several bans against showing skulls in media and entertainment, and thus it has been changed massively in order to appeal to this market. I don't want to get too heavily into my thoughts on this, as I'm sure you can guess, but this is a massive departure from the original look for the character for Disney to basically sell the film internationally. Anyway, at the moment he looks more like Lord Zedd from the Power Rangers than Taskmaster, but hey, I guess Marvel don't want to cause problems with their second biggest box office generators. Anyway, we'll now be going into talking about the plot leak for the movie, so if you don't want to know anything about what could be a big reveal in the film, then I highly suggest that you turn off now. These are leaks and as such should be taken with a pinch of salt, but just in case you don't want anything ruined, then this is the point you need to dive out of the video. If you're still here, thanks for sticking with me, but according to the leaks on the film, Taskmaster will actually be a double agent named Rick Mason, who is an ex-flame of Widow. Throughout the film, Widow and her quote-unquote family will be using Mason for assistance, and this is how he is able to keep track of their movements and stalk them throughout the movie. There are also spoilers that one of Widow's teammates is the head of the shadowy organization that we see in the trailer training future Black Widows, and that he will be working alongside this character. I've spoiled who that is in my trailer breakdown, but I just wanted to keep it out of this video in case you don't want to know who that is. Rick Mason will be played by Otee Fagbenle, whose name I've definitely just butchered. I'm not even kidding, I'm guessing this happens a lot because online people just call him OT in Hollywood, so yeah, at least I'm not the only one. And apparently he will be revealed as the duplicitous character at the end of the film. Again, take all that with a pinch of salt, and if you're watching this video in the future and have already seen the movie and I'm wrong, then yeah, sorry for being an idiot, you can call me an idiot in the comments if you want. Either way, I can't wait to see the film, and I'm so glad that we are finally getting a live-action version of the character on the big screen, as he's definitely one of the best villains in the Marvel Universe, and who knows, going forward, they may even bring him into some of the teams that the universe is setting up at the moment. Obviously, I'd love to hear your thoughts on Taskmaster and what you'd like to see in the movie. Comment below and let me know, and if you enjoyed this video then please give it a thumbs up, and make sure you check out our full breakdown of the Black Widow trailer, which will be linked at the end. We go over everything you missed and give our best fan theories on what will happen in the film, so it's definitely worth checking out if you want to know more. If you want to come chat to me after the video, then make sure you follow me on Twitter at DefinitionYT, or head over to my Discord server, which will be linked in the description below. We drop videos on there early, so if you want to see stuff before anyone else, then that's the best place to be. It's free to join and we have an awesome community, so hopefully I see you over there very soon. We're also giving away a free copy of the Marvel Phase 3 Part 2 box set on Blu-ray, which contains Black Panther, Infinity War, Endgame, Captain Marvel and more, and all you have to do to be in with a chance of winning is like the video, make sure you subscribe to the channel, and leave your thoughts on Taskmaster in the comments section below. The winner is going to be chosen at random on the 15th of December, and the set will be shipped out from then to whoever gets the prize, so best of luck to everyone who takes part. This is a channel for people who are super into superheroes, so if that's the kind of thing you like, hit subscribe. Thank you for taking the time to watch this. I've been Definition, you've been the best, and I'll see you next time. Take care, peace.